Hello guys, welcome to our 10 boat essentials. Today we're gonna show you 10 things that make our life easier aboard. They're not very obvious, they are not like must have, just as a dinghy or a life vest. They are stuff that we found along the way that have been making our life much, much easier. So let's get started.
Hi guys, so number one of my essential items, I'll talk about lights. So headlamp, this item here is an essential because it helps me a lot during maintenance, engine or electrical, any small compartment. It's very handy. I like to have it and, you know, have two free hands. And also during night sailing, it's excellent to have to move around the cockpit or to go ahead in an emergency. Whenever I have crew coming on board, I tell them, please bring a headlamp with you. Even better if it's water resistant or waterproof and rechargeable. This one has a cool feature. You just move your hands and lights on, lights off. I like that. Also, talking about lights, there's something that became hugely popular among cruisers, and there's a reason for it. It's the Lucy lights. Lucy lights are this cute inflatable lights. They are solar powered. The battery charges itself in a few hours on the sun, and it lasts for 5 or 6 hours. They have great price. It's something around 20, 25 bucks. There's different models. And we got like the first one nearly 4 years ago. Since then, we've seen it everywhere, and many, many cruisers have it, and many cruisers have like plenty. This is a favorite and a must have. And this one here, also very important item.
Who haven't ever dropped something important into the water? That's why dry bags are our number two boat essentials. Dry bags are very, very useful on a boat. We have been using it for years, and it's a lifesaver. Even to drop something to the water, like a computer, or we carry also cameras, cell phones, paper documents, but also from the rain. Many times we are at the dinghy and it starts raining or things like that, so they are really, really useful. We have ones that are like backpacks. These are good ones, also very different sizes. I also like the small ones that you can just put your phone and a money and just go to land or wherever you want to go. So yeah, this is a lifesaver. Get one if you live on a boat. These are very, very important.
Number three essential items, it's the bungee cords. I love these guys here. Very useful attaching things on deck, putting tarpons to protect from rain catcher. I use it a lot. Have different sizes, different lengths, different colors. So I really like it. Everybody has seen it. It's not only a boat essential, it's a home essential as well. So very useful, cheap, and makes a lot of difference in a hurry. You don't need to tie knots, you just go in.
Boat hack number four, bottled sprayer. Well, I have many sprayers, as you can see, because I think they are very useful on a boat. It seems like, why? This is just a sprayer, very simple, very cheap, perfect. I use them for many different reasons. In some of them, I mix water and vinegar, so I can wash the boat with this. I can remove salt when we are sailing from the cockpit. It's very good for mold also. So instead of using a lot of expensive products to clean the boat, I basically use it vinegar and water. So that's a good tip also. I also make homemade repellent sometimes, but my favorite one is to wash the dishes. This is a very good water saver. So I mix a little bit of liquid soap with water, so it won't make so much foam when you wash the dishes. And this is what you need most of the water, like to remove all that foam. So with this, it still cleans the dishes, but just saves water. I spray it a little bit, then I use a sponge to clean it and fresh water to rinse, and there we go, we are ready. Didn't use that much water, and a very cheap and easy solution. In our old boat, we used to have a pressure sprayer. This was nice also. We didn't have a shower outside, so the pressure sprayer was a nice option. It used very, very little water. You just pump it, so it will get some pressure, and then you wash whatever you want, you take a shower, Well, it's not much water, it's just like very thin spray, but it helps. We use that for, I don't know, more than a year, I think. That's number four, very easy, simple and cheap hack. Since we are talking about water, let's talk about our boat essential number five. Last year, when we were in Panama before crossing, we bought a simple water filter. We just attach it to our tap. It's a carbon activated filter, and we also have a ceramic filter before the tap, so it's just double filtration, perfect. It makes life so much easier. We abolished plastic bottles. We don't buy water in bottles anymore. This is great, and we have been drinking it for, I don't know, more than a year now. And we didn't have any trouble, so this is really a nice thing to have on your boat and your home also, not only on a boat. Why not drink filtrated water? Just don't buy like plastic bottles, expensive water, whatever. So it's a nice solution, cheap and eco-friendly.
Number six, my Jedi sword. This is called the Bad Boy. It's an internet booster. With this, we have access to Wi-Fi far away from the boat. You can imagine how useful this thing is. This is an antenna that gets the signal from a distant Wi-Fi up to 3 miles. Well, according to specifications, but sometimes it's not this much. But we got some Wi-Fi really distance eventually if there's no obstructions. From this, it's connected to a router and spread internet to the whole boat. Still, you have to have the Wi-Fi password for that specific connection you're trying. Here in Polynesia, there are a lot of internet hotspots, and this improved the signal hugely. So instead of just upload a video in the streets or close to antenna, we can do it safely from the boat. There's different brands, you can search on Amazon for different models. It's like 200, 300 bucks. But in our case, we depends a lot from internet, as you can imagine. So it was really worth the investment.
Boat essentials number seven, fans. Well, if you live or sail in the tropics, you know what I'm talking about. It's really warm during the day and during the night, so fans are essential things on a boat. We use it 99% of the time. We have good ones spread all around the boat, so you can use in every corner that you can fit it. We have different brands. We use Hella Turbo and Caframo. I don't know how to pronounce it. I don't know even where they are from, but they are very nice brands. They are not cheap, but they are good. They last long and they have different speeds. Well, speeds are not very important because we always use in the max, so whatever. I advise you to put one in your room so to sleep it's nice, because you have some fresh air, and also for the mosquitoes. In the galley is a nice one also, because it gets really warm when you are cooking inside. It's just spread fans all over the place.
Oh, hi. Number eight, essential items. It's the Kindle or an e-reader. I especially like the Kindle. This is an old one, there's nearly 10 years, but it's still going strong. This e-reader holds like countless books, and you know, in a boat, space, it's a very important limitation. So with the Kindle, you can put all those books here and no space taken. We do have many books, physical books, on our shelves, but most of our readings are here. We can keep it here. Especially helpful on long passages. Before going, you just download 20 books. It's nearly impossible to get bored. We don't have like libraries accessible all the time, you know, but we do have with this.
Georgia, stop this noise! I'm hangover!
Well, guys, I had to add this one to the list. So number nine, boat essential, it's a portable vacuum cleaner. We have been using this for a while at the boat, and it just makes life very much easier, because you can put it inside any corner of the boat, places that are difficult to reach. Also for maintenance, when we are sanding or making a lot of mess, you just vacuum it and it's so much easier. These ones are cordless, doesn't have a cord, and also it's 12 volts, rechargeable, so this is easy. In the boat it's perfect because you can take it everywhere. So yes, number 9 is just a cleaning tool, but very useful.
Tenth and last item from the list, it's paddleboard. I wanted to shoot this from the paddleboard, but Georgia said no. Light, sounds, and all this technical stuff. So here I am. And paddleboard, it's a great exercise, good for the core, good for your back. Excellent way to explore the reefs. You go chilling, just watching the marine life underneath you. Not only it's a good exercise, it's a good way to explore locations. It's actually a way to go around. We spent recently 3 months without a dinghy, and we could only rely on our paddle boards to go ashore. We got 2 inflatable boards from Goose Hill, and especially good, they don't occupy any space on deck. We just store it and that's it. Really cool. I love to go on a morning ride when the sun is not too high. You just go chilling, take Georgia for a romantic ride, exploring the surroundings. So that's boat essentials number 10. And bonus, this one is not an essential, but it's a new addition to our gear and we are really stoked to have it. It's a foldable bike. I understand that's not for everybody because sometimes space is a limitation, but we got 2 recently and it's a game changer. When we go to a new place and you need to explore it, it just makes life so much easier. We can increase our horizons and explore further and carry groceries. So I'm really stoked we have it. We have a pair of it and it's really nice. Whenever we got on the boat, we store it, put in a locker, and to go ashore, throw in the dinghy, get there, unfold it, and we are ready to move. So if you have this possibility and you are unsure, just like, oh no, whether you're gonna use it or not, yes, you're gonna use it, and it's really cool to have it. Well, this is our 10 boat essentials list, and please drop in the comments your essential items, either if you live aboard or in a motorhome or in a house. Let us know what you cannot live without. These items we suggest you, there's no advertisement or anything like that. It's because we use it and we feel that we can recommend from our own experience.
If you like our content, please consider to become a patron. You get many privileges. Some of them is to be the first one to know about crew opportunities with us. You get the chance to come on board. Also, you get access to our exclusive patrons group and many other rewards. Check our page in the description below to see the full list. And if you are new here, please subscribe to more content. See you soon!